Hey there, I'm Merv Lapus, and I love using Evernote to keep myself organized.
And I'm Erin Wilkie-O. I prefer the app Notability for all my note-taking needs.
Yeah, but for use in the classroom, which one do you think is better?
That's a great question, Merv. Let's take a look at both tools side by side.
This is the second installment of our EdTech Quick Take series, Evernote versus Notability.
We'll compare some key features and look at how students and teachers use these tools in the classroom.
Let's take a look. Both Evernote and Notability are powerful tools for note-taking and organization.
With either tool, users can organize notes into folders, and everything's saved in the cloud, so you can access, search, and edit your notes on the fly.
And both tools let you add a variety of content, from text to handwritten notes, photos, audio recordings, and more. But for classroom use, there's one important difference you should know about right up front. Evernote syncs to any device through its own cloud storage system.
Whereas Notability syncs between a user's Apple devices using an iCloud account. Also, the Notability app does play pretty well with other cloud storage tools.
Still, when it comes to access for all students, this might make Evernote the only choice in some classrooms.
That's true, but we shouldn't overlook Notability. Even if you don't have a one-to-one iPad program, Notability has unique features that make it great for students. For starters, Notability's note playback feature. Students can type notes and record audio simultaneously. The audio automatically syncs up to the correct places within the note.
Evernote does let users insert audio clips, but not like that. At least not yet.
Also, Notability has built-in drawing and sketching tools. These are really helpful, especially when paired with the handy Zoom tool. You can get super detailed. And overall, the app's interface seems a bit more kid-friendly.
That's really useful to know. We should also mention how some teachers are using these tools to share documents with students and parents.
Right. You can almost use them like a basic LMS.
Exactly. Evernote's shared notebooks let teachers send and receive notes and documents with their students, or even groups of students. There are lots of possibilities. And students and teachers can collaborate on notes, even in the free version. And the new chat feature could also be helpful.
In Notability, you can share notes with other users, but only using email or a cloud service like Dropbox or Google Drive. It's still pretty simple, but maybe not quite as seamless.
So when it comes down to it, which app is best for education?
For any Apple one-to-one classrooms or for individual students, Notability is a solid choice. Plus, it's under $3.
But for the most accessibility across devices, which is a big deal in most schools, Evernote's probably the stronger option, and the free version comes with a lot of functionality.
So, which app works best for your classroom?
Tell us what you think, and check out our reviews of all the best EdTech tools at Common Sense Education.